Where were we? Oh yeah, the most boring hippie party ever. Probably because I don't want to call him Jeremiah Stokes, because that's dumb. I was thinking Jeremiah Spock is good, because his robe. But really, I just want to keep calling him Fishmouth. Fishmouth used to be a hippie. He had some crappy music. It was like a Christian rock, but not rock. It was boring Christian hippie music. And then he became a cult leader, because, you know, why not?
He's moving in. He's kneeling down. He's blurry and wavy, and he's getting close to Mandy. She doesn't care. Does she blink? Ever? Does he? Ah, shit, we got a close-up on his face. He's gonna monologue, I guess. When I was at the bottom of the pit, screaming in the darkness, racked with unspeakable pain, something having been denied all that was rightfully mine, he graced me with his pipe. Oh, he's talking about Abraxas. His heart? What? Something like flowed over me like the pulse of a timeless wave. Meanwhile, as we get this line, the timeless wave line, we're getting a superimposition of Mandy's face over his face, because they both got the really big dark eyes. And I guess it's for a reason. Oh, wait. If you're gonna do the superimposition, shouldn't her face also be talking? Because his is still talking and her mouth is still. That's not good. If you're gonna create this effect of they're the same person or they're merging in some way or something, it should match. I'm just saying. That's this whole show. I'm just saying. Oh, but this episode cuts off the timeless wave thing anyway, so it doesn't matter. Ugh. Sometimes you hit pause too slowly. Float over me like a timeless wave. How does that flow over you any differently than a normal wave? Ugh. It's like the prose from the book she was reading. Like, why is the warlock wretched? Why were there two red suns? Why was any of it? Why are there adjectives? Insert visual of me shaking my head instead of talking.
I don't have time for this today.
That's not even my desk.